This is the Discovery Files from the U.S. National Science Foundation. Today we are joined by Dr. Joanna Schisler, and she's going to explain what a virus is.
So I like to define viruses as very small particles that are consisting of genetic material, so genes, that are protected by a protein-based coat, kind of protects the RNA and the DNA. The genetic material that some viruses have is DNA, so that's something that you and I have that makes up our own genomes. Other viruses have RNA, and that's a little bit different. So what you see is a really amazing variety of viruses when it comes to shapes and sizes. We're starting to get an appreciation for how viruses can actually be helpful to us as humans. So we used to think of viruses as very rare things that would happen to us, right? So normally we don't have any viruses except for when we come down with a cold. What we're starting to understand is that actually there are a lot of viruses that are in different parts of our body and at different times. And so there's estimates that there are around 380 trillion viruses either inside or on the surface of our bodies at any time. It's really fascinating because we're thinking about trillions of viruses, and when you think about our own microbiomes, you're thinking about billions of bacterial cells. So when you think about yourself as a whole, there's actually probably more viruses and bacteria than there are human cells that make you up. There's only a few ways that viruses can spread. With COVID, we've learned about respiratory droplets and how important that is. So if you're thinking about how to protect yourself from respiratory viruses, then you want to think about, you know, covering your cough or wearing a mask or sneezing into a tissue and then throwing that tissue away. Viruses can also be spread by the fecal-oral route, viruses that replicate in the intestine and come out in feces, and then people are not very clean with their hands and they'll then put their hands to their mouths or their eyeballs. People are now working on being able to collect viruses from the air. They talk about the air virome to be able to detect what's in the air. So I think we're at an amazing time where we can sample and also detect viruses at a very early stage, even before humans or other animals become sick.